Welcome back to Istamera online classes. My dears, in our previous class, we have learned some information regarding STEM. That is, STEM is the main thing which is essential for a plant, which holds the plant upright. And the next thing is, it supplies water or it transports water, food and minerals to all body parts of the plant. And the next thing what we have learned after this is, some plants even carries food in their stem, and I have told you example, that is sugarcane. This is what the recollection of the things which we have learned in our previous class. Next up to that, now we shall learn over the parts of the stem. That is, a main thing which is very important is about leaf. Which is main thing which is very important for the plant, that is leaf. As we prepare food in our kitchen, plants prepare their food in leaf. So that leaf is called as food factory of a plant. Food factory of plant. Leaf is called as the food factory of the plant. Now, I will show you what are the parts of the leaf that contains. Where this is a leaf, a flat part where leaf consists, it is called as leaf blade. Where it contains some extra channel-like structures. Can you see this here? They are called as vines. The main vein which is running at the middle of the leaf is called as midvein. And there are some tiny particles which are present in the leaf which we cannot see. But that tiny spores which present in the leaf help the plants to breathe. They are called as stomata. Now my dear, see here. The main vein which is passing at the middle of the leaf is called midvein, midrib or midvein, midrib. The next thing, the lines which are the channel-like structures which are present in the leaf are called as veins. The flattened part of the leaf is called as leaf blade. Leaf blade or lamina. Next to this, a tiny pores which are present in the leaf which are not seen by our naked eyes. Such things are called as stomata. Yes, my dears, the veins, the flattened part of the leaf is called vein, leaf blade or leaf lamina. The flattened part of the leaf is called as leaf blade or leaf lamina. The veins which are running, the channels like structures which are present in the leaf are called veins. The main thing which is passing in the middle of the leaf is called leaf blade, sorry, midrib. And the tiny spores which are present in the leaf are called as stomata. My dears, the leaf, whichever you are seeing around you, are all of same kind and same shape, same color? No. No other leaves are similar to one another. All the leaves which are present in our surroundings are differing from one or another thing. Now, after seeing the leaf or parts of the leaf, we shall just discuss what are the functions of the leaf. What are the functions of the leaf? Where functions of the leaf are like that, like it prepares food. It prepares food. It helps plants for breathing. Sorry, it prepares food. It helps for breathing. For what? Which thing does it help for breathing? Yes, while the process of photosynthesis is going to take place. My dears, what is photosynthesis? That you will learn in our next class, that is grade 4. But just think, just keep it in your mind that plant prepares food. That is known as process of preparing food is known as photosynthesis. While the process of photosynthesis is going to take place, or while plants are preparing food, there will be exchange of gases. So that is through the leaf, and therefore leaf helps plants for breathing. Not only this is the main important thing of the leaf or function of the leaf, some plants also stores food in them. For example, spinach, coriander. Next to this, it even helps the human being in the process of breathing. Why? Because while the food is going to be prepared in the plants, they take in carbon dioxide and give out oxygen, where oxygen is the very important gas for the human beings to breathe. Therefore, this leaves directly or indirectly helps the human beings in the process of breathing. Yes, my dears, until this we have completed the parts of the leaf. Like it can, parts of the plant contain two things like stem and root, where root is again of two types, like fibrous root. And the next thing is stem root. After this, stem consists of again some divisions like branches, fruit, flower, and leaf. The main thing which is these are all the things from which we have started our lesson, where plant is divided into two kinds like stem and root, where root consists of two types like fibrous root and trunk root. Stem consists of leaf, branches, fruits, flowers. And until now we have completed two main things, like we have completely studied about the roots, and about stem we have got the knowledge. And in that stem, we have learned the leaf. Tomorrow, in our next class, we shall learn our these three main important things. Until then, take care. Bye. Thank you.